In this video, we'll go over the steps on how to data bind a report using Entity Framework. First thing we need to do is add the data. I right-click on the project and choose Add New Item. Select the Data tab and choose the ADO.NET Entity Data Model. I'll call it Northwind and hit Add. I want to generate the model from a database, so I click Next, and here I'll make a new connection. I'll bind to the local server, select the Northwind database, and click OK. I'll save the entity connection as Northwind Entities and click Next. Now I'll select the Categories table and click Finish to complete the wizard. Next, we need to add a new report. I'll right-click and add a new item. Under Reporting, choose the DExperience Report class, give it a name, and click OK. Now I'll go to the Solution Explorer and find the Category class under Northwind. You'll see here that it's a plain CLR object with no database-specific information or logic for pulling data. So first, I'll compile the project, then use this class. We have to go to the Report Smart Tag and add a new project data source. The Data Configuration Wizard appears. Here, I'll choose Object and click Next. Now drill down into Reports, choose the Category table, and click Finish. Once completed, you'll see all available fields show up in the field list. Next, I'll drop the category name field onto the design surface and resize it. You'll notice that when I go to preview the report, there's no data shown. This is because the category class has no logic for accessing data. In our dataset example, table adapters were automatically built in to provide the mechanism for accessing data. I'll show you how to fix this using scripting. First, we need to tell our scripting engine where Entity Framework lives. So I'll scroll down to the Script References property and click on the ellipsis. A script editor appears, and here I can add a path to Entity Framework. This is located in the Packages folder inside of Entity Framework because it used NuGet to pull the assembly. Now we need to add the data logic via a special event. I'll create a new event for the onDataSourceDemanded script. Here, I'll make sure to include the appropriate using statements. Next, I'll set the data source of the report using DataSource and create a new Northwind Entities class. Select the Categories table and materialize it using the ToList feature. Lastly, we need to add a reference to the Windows Form Assembly and hit OK. Now, when we go to preview the report, you'll see our list of category names appear. And that's how you data bind to Entity Framework 5. Thanks for watching, and thanks for choosing DevExpress.